Hey everyone, Grant for the Flame Learning Channel. In this short video, I'm going to show you how to slip your media under a time warp or speed change effect. This is quite useful when you've built a time warp or conformed a sequence with speed changes and you just want to adjust the timing of the underlying media. In other words, the idea is to keep the keyframes of the time warp at the same frames, but slip the footage underneath. So here is a sequence containing a clip with a speed change or speed ramp. In this case, the bus is accelerated into the bus stop and is slowed to regular speed as it pulls in. So the time warp is applied to the segment, and you can see the time warp timeline effects in the effects bar, and the segment displays the two keyframes for the speed change. If you want to see the physical animation curve, you could jump into the timeline effects editor and look at the animation editor for the curve. However, to keep it simple, all you need to do is slip the media under the time warp. Now, if you switched the edit mode to slip, either through the pull-down menu or press Alt-S, when you slip the segment, the keyframes are locked to the media and are slipped along with the footage. So that method won't work. Just undo the slip to go back to the original state. Instead of stripping the time warp off the segment, slipping the media, and then reapplying the time warp timeline effects, all you need to do is adjust the timing in the timeline effects. So a good tip is to navigate to a specific time in the segment where you want to ensure a specific source frame will occur at that point in time. It can be used to line up with an offline reference if you have one, but it simply removes any guesswork when you slip the media against the speed change. So I've placed my positioner on a keyframe where the footage returns to its normal frame rate. Go to the timing slider and adjust the timings of your footage. Please note that the time warp keyframes do not move this time. So this is how you can slip your media underneath a speed change or speed ramp. Technically, the timing value is the playback rate of your media on a linear curve, and the speed value is the independent control on top of the timing, which can create speed changes when using the speed mode in the time warp timeline effects. I hope you found this quick tip useful, and please be sure to check out the other workflows, features, and enhancements to the Flame 2018.1 update. Comments, feedback, and suggestions are always welcome and appreciated. Thank you for watching, and please subscribe to the Flame Learning channel for future videos.